It has come to this stage. This is the metallurgical propagation along the grain boundaries. Now the cracks got the sufficient depth. Okay? Once it got the sufficient depth, now here the stress, that is called CTOD. What is CTOD? What is CTOD? All are mechanical engineers. This is a mechanical metallurgy, mechanical fracture mechanics. What is CTOD?
Cold temperature.
Mr. Bharia.
CTOD.
That is called crack tip depth opening. Mm-hmm. Okay. Crack tip depth opening.
CTO.
CTOD. Crack tip depth opening. It is a very popular term for all expert or non-expert. Everyone should know this. CTOD. Okay? Now this, if the crack is size, if this is called CTOD, this is the depth of this crack. Suppose this is the tip, the crack tip is here, then this is the depth of the crack. That is called CTOD. Now if the CTOD has increased to its critical value, where the cyclic loading is taking place and the crack becomes self-sustaining. Self-sustaining means it starts moving mechanically because of the stress. Now it was taking the help of the grain boundaries because grain boundaries were weaker. And there was earlier it has taken the help of the notch. And then it has taken the help of the grain boundaries to propagate. But once it has come to this, now the crack is self-sustaining. Now it will not see whether it is grain boundaries or whether it is granular or transgranular. Whether it is going within the grain or along the grain. That will be self-sustaining. Now, in this crack, if I am loading, it will create the dislocations. Slip, by slip, I told you yesterday. Yes. And if the cycle of this, your loading and unloading is more, more and more dislocation will be collected here. And every dislocation, there is the absence of the plane. So what happens? This is the absence of plane, this is the absence of plane, this is the atom. And they are already collected over a row at the tip of the cap. Now what will happen? All will combine.
Form a big one.
And they will move. Cap will move. And then you have done the unloading. Okay. Unloading. Crack has moved already. Now again you are loading. One dislocation again generated. Again unloading. Another dislocation. Like this, it will go on jumping. Not clear?
Clear.
And what will happen? The movement of this crack as the it is traveling more and more. What will happen? The travel rate will increase or decrease?
Increase.
Travel rate will increase. You see? It is increasing. No?
Yes.
Is it not? And at one point, that this material, whatever is left over, its yield strength is not equal to the required strength for the operation, then what will happen to this?
Failure.
Catastrophic failure. Okay? So that is the mechanisms of it. Many very good quality material, which we think this is nickel, 100% nickel. It has failed. How it has failed? 40. Clean. If you do not know, you will be confused. Someone will say nickel has failed. Something wrong in the material. Some heat treatment problem was there. Like that. So, material failure becomes a mystery. Why the material has failed? So you have to reach to the real root cause analysis. How can you reach to the real root cause analysis? If you have the full knowledge of these mechanisms, how the failures take place, what happens, then you can reach to the root cause, whether it is operating failure, whether it is material failure. Okay? So this is regarding, this is called the mechanical failure. This is a good diagram?
Yes.
Yes.
I have done lot of labor.
Yes, sir.
Not only this, sir. Not only this, thousands of
it will take a thousand of days, sir, maybe. LinkedIn also, and I have seen these things, sir.
You have seen, na?
Yeah, I have seen.
So it is not my, it is my habit. Whatever I am having with me, I should pass on first. And that's why I might have given over 2,500 or 3,000 posts on the LinkedIn. Mm-hmm. Now we are coming to a very wonderful topic. Okay. Which will open your mystery and it will remove your confusion. Otherwise, you will get confused yourself and you will confuse others. सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम ये है कि सपोज आई विल आई हैव बिकम दिस आई वाज द दिस करोजन एक्सपर्ट करोजन मटेरियल एक्सपर्ट ओके सो सम पीपल दे वांट टू यूज मी दे विल से आई से रस्तोगी से लिखवा लो कुछ कि दिस इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड दिस इज ओके है ना बिकॉज दे डू नॉट वांट टू स्पेंड मनी है ना हर एक आदमी का मोटिव अलग अलग होता है नाउ यू सी यू आर इफ यू आर नॉट ए एक्सपर्ट तो टू इफ यू आर सेविंग अदर्स बट यू मे बी लैंडेड इन ए बिग प्रॉब्लम इज इट सपोज समवन इंटेंशन योर बॉस इंटेंशन इज दैट अब डारेन था ना वहां पे हिज इंटेंशन इज दैट ही डू नॉट वांट टू स्पेंड मनी ओके भाई बट यू हैव टू बी वेरी एक्सपर्ट And you can help enough. This is the wonders actually. You see, it does not mean that corrosion expert is only spoiling the your balance sheet. No. He can make your balance sheet. It is not that if Ambani refineries are failing there in the Jamnagar all the time and every day one people is dying. This is a very bad situation. Every day one person is dying in Reliance. I was in Gujarat last time, this thing I did, people came from there. That is the situation. And if suppose others are dying, my number may also be there. I can also be there. So, you have to be very judgmental. Judgment is it. And judgment is not located in the books, in the old standard. That's why I always say that your knowledge only can help you. Otherwise, I say that someone is paying me very well, or things fail. Now you see, if A, this should be law, or somewhere it has become the law. If the people die, accident take place, catastrophe happens, people die, then the punishment should be life for life. You know?
Yes.
Life against life. Then you will see how much quality will improve. If Ambani, people are dying and he, the law is there that Ambani will be hanged, you will see that how the quality will move fast. That is the problem. Life against life. That should be the law.
People working in India, they are not maintaining the quality. Same people working in Dubai, Gulf, they are maintaining the quality. Afraid for that imprisonment.
They will spoil all the things. Now you see, $100 people are going from India to Saudi Arabia for working. Who has made this situation? Indians.
Yes.
These are Indians who have discredited this there. Only Indians have taught them that people are available from India in 100 terms. And Western people are asking $3,000.
Correct.
Now you see?
For saying.
Who has made this situation? Indians.
Indians.
Bargaining. How selfish we are. This is very bad. This is not. So the another topic which I am going to cover here is very important, and we should try to understand. Otherwise, people always, I have seen, this is being appreciated by a big person. Once I have put up this on LinkedIn, this slide. We should understand how the corrosion take place, what causes the corrosion, and what expedite the corrosion.
Accelerate.
Okay? So you see here, what is corrosion? Corrosion requires the matter, corrosion requires the water, corrosion requires the oxidizing agent.
Yes.
I ask in the morning, why I am having metal, I am having water, whether the corrosion will take place?
No.
No. It will not. Okay? Without oxidizing agent, corrosion will not take place. Please keep this thing in mind. You are intellectual people. All of you are intellectual. So you have to think intellectually. And talk intellectually. If suppose you say, okay, if suppose I say, I put up in this water, and water there is no oxygen, and I ask you whether the corrosion will take place, you say corrosion, yes, corrosion will take place. No, because we have not understood corrosion. Okay? Although these things looks to be very simple once I tell you, but once you generate these things, it's difficult. Generating the things, talking in this term. Because books may, you will not find, these things are written just like that, I will go through standard, I will go through books, and they are clearly written. What is causing corrosion? What is accelerating corrosion? No, where you will find. So this take your thought process. Out of thought process these things comes. So you see, corrosion will occur once the oxidizing agent is there, when the metal is there, when the water is there.
Then corrosion
will
start. Then corrosion will start.
If anything is missing, the corrosion will not be there.
Yes.
But suppose if the water is missing, As in the case of heater, a lot of firing is taking place inside and I get lot of oxidation, scale formation. You get or not?
Yes.
So, this is corrosion or not?
Yes, it's corrosion, sir.
But water is not there.
Vapor is there?
Huh?
Steam. Vapor or steam?
No, nothing is there. Why? You have seen the heater? There is any vapor? No vapor. Only there is water. Why? There is a
steam.
Heat and flue gases. Or oxygen for the burning? These are the thing only. So why the corrosion this scale has formed? This is also corrosion.
With the help of flame, oxygen.
Yeah, oxidation. Right. Now you see, there is support over this. These tubes are having the support. Now here, the S, flue gas S is getting deposited. And because there is no heat flow here, okay, in the support system, that is getting corroded. There is no water there. What is that corrosion is called?
Oxidation.
What is that corrosion called here? On the supports of the tube outside.
Revice.
Is okay. But what is that terminology of this type of corrosion? Not type of corrosion, corrosion. Phenomena. That is called fuel-less corrosion.
This is happening in supports.
Supports, where the S is getting deposited, and if S has got the vanadium, okay, then these things are getting corroded. Fuel-less corrosion. This is also corrosion. The oxide is forming on the here. This oxide, water. What is water? Water. I can write. It is not water. It is electrolyte. Water acts as an electrolyte. So if it is a wet corrosion, then it is water. If it is a dry corrosion, then it is water. It is a dry corrosion.
Yeah.
There are two types of the corrosion.
Oxygen.
Wet corrosion, dry corrosion.
Yeah.
All high temperature corrosion, they are the dry corrosion. And all stress corrosion cracking, they are the wet corrosion. All pitting corrosion, crevice corrosion, wet corrosion. This is the oxide. So where is the electrolyte? Without electrolyte, corrosion cannot take place. Because it requires the flow of electrons. So, here, whatever this oxide has formed, that acts as an electrolyte. Whatever the solid oxide is formed, that acts as an electrolyte. We will see this. So don't think this water means electrolyte. Corrosion requires the electrolyte so that the electrons can flow. And electrons can flow in the solid side. That is called dry
corrosion.
So here you can see this is the oxygen. There you can see this is the CO2. There you can see this is the H2S. Okay? Now oxygen corrosion rate is the highest. Oxygen is the biggest or highest corrosive agent. After that, this is the CO2. And H2S is less. Okay? So among these are called the oxidizing agents. And if you see here, among oxidizing agents, oxygen is 50 times more corrosive than CO2. And 100 times more corrosive than H2S. Okay? If you see this. So, that is why nitrogen purging is needed during the idling of the equipment. Not clear? If you want to bring down the equipment, you have to keep in them the nitrogen purging, because oxygen air enter into it.
To reduce the percentage.
And the corrosion will be very fast by the oxygen. So, idling and maximum corrosion of equipment occurs when? In the running condition or during the turnaround?
Turnaround.
In running condition, the plant is running, there is no oxygen there.
No will be there, sir.
Only once you take the plant down, then the maximum corrosion.
Yes.
This fact you should try to understand. If you understand this slides, this is the high level of appreciation I got on these slides from various countries. Because this is clarifying you the total picture of the corrosion. Okay? So, corrosion of equipment occurs during the turnaround when equipment's opened and exposed to the humid air for a long time. So if suppose your life of the asset is 30 years and you have taken the, how much shutdown you have taken, suppose in the Bina refinery in 5 years they have taken 70 shutdown.
70.
Okay, that BPCL refinery.
Bharat Aman refinery.
So, one thing is there, this idling causes the maximum problem of corrosion. After idling, the stagnation causes the maximum problem of the corrosion. Okay, stagnation. And then the velocity, flow rate, that causes the erosion corrosion. So you see there are the two types of the factor